One fall, a 60-minute time limit for the heavyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, the challenger out of Tampa Bay, Florida. He weighed in at 228 pounds. He is gorgeous, Jimmy Garvin. Introducing the heavyweight champion of the world, out of Quebec City, Canada, at 238 pounds, here's Rick Martel. Accompanied by his valet, Big Bertha von Raschke. One full 60-minute time.
Well, how do you describe this? Big Bertha von Raschke, the valet for the heavyweight champion of the world, Rick Martel. On the other side of the ring, Jimmy Garvin getting out of his garb. Take a look at Big Bertha. And I mean Big Bertha. Beautiful Big Bertha von Raschke. Words just can't quite describe it.
I've seen it all now.
Yeah. Live long enough, you will see it all. And Bertha.
Stop. As you know, Larry Nelson, in the past, Precious has had a great deal of influence on the outcome of some of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin's matches.
Ken Resnick, you are not without influence. You think you can get me a date with Bertha?
You have to take that up with Rick Martel, I suppose. But anyways, Larry, other wrestlers have wanted to take a shot, if you will, at Precious for her interference. Big Bertha is on record as saying a man can't go after a woman, but in this case, if Precious should try and get out of line, Bertha has no problem a woman going after a woman. And you talk about having a valet that has a main squeeze of his or her own. The claw is about as big a squeeze as you'll find anywhere on this planet.
All right, this is stone serious business here. Rick Martel. They're psyching Jimmy Garvin out. Now, normally, this is Jimmy's routine. He psychs out his opponent with the help of Precious, with all of his garb. But I gotta tell you, the way it's working right now, Garvin is going absolutely insane. Precious eating every second of it, as Big Bertha is helping the champion get ready. Now look out, now look out. Bertha's starting to lose its sense of humor.
I tell you, you can say what you want, but I guess if I was going to have anybody in my corner, I think I'd want it to be Big Bertha.
Rick Martel, Jimmy Garvin. Bloody history between these two, and I mean bloody. The heavyweight championship of the world on the line. All of this that you're seeing here is fun to talk about, is very interesting. But it's also very important from a psychological point of view.
And when the bell rings, Larry Nelson, it will be all business, because don't forget for one instant, at stake the heavyweight championship of the world.
Absolutely. There's the bell. Rick Martel trying to take the psychological advantage away from Jimmy Garvin. In fact, turn it around on him with a valet of his own. He did it. However, Bertha and Precious out of the ring now. We're going to get down to a serious wrestling match. Rick Martel, we don't have to expound upon his credentials. He's the heavyweight champion of the world. He got there because he is a great wrestler. Do not underestimate Jimmy Garvin. His tactics are treacherous. He does rely on some distraction from his valet, but this man is a sensational wrestler in his own right and a very intelligent one. Right now, he's ranting and raving in the ring, with Martel stalking him.
Well, one thing we can see that we've never seen before, Larry Nelson, Jimmy Garvin distracted on his own this time by the presence of Big Bertha von Raschke.
Garvin with the first hold, but he doesn't keep it long. Martel throws out of it. Thank you. in trouble, and now the Baron going after Precious outside the ring, showing the clock. Or, excuse me, Bertha outside the ring.
The Baron's sister, if you want to take a look at this. You talk about something that can keep law and order at ringside. It's certainly Big Bertha. Jimmy Garvin doesn't know which way to turn. He's not only got to worry about Rick Martel, but he's got to worry about Precious at ringside, what with the presence of Big Bertha. And there's a close-up of Big Bertha von Raschke.
And you know that crowd loves it. And Rick Martel, look at his intensity. He knows what he's here to do. Defend the heavyweight championship of the world that he has worked for almost all his adult life to achieve. Collar and elbow, Garvin with an eye gouge. Jimmy Garvin will find a way, usually, to overcome any obstacle in a wrestling ring and get his victory, but he's in there with the best in the business right now. Garvin in control. That's why he's the heavyweight champion of the world. Ooh. And he's coming right at the advantage he created. Rick Martel splitting the legs of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. The crowd loves it.
Okay, Larry, now there's Precious up on the ring apron. Now take a look, Big Bertha. Now you can see it. She's getting up on the ring apron, and she's ordering Precious right back to the corner. As I was going to say, Larry, Rick Martel, since defeating Jumbo Tsuruta for the heavyweight championship of the world at the St. Paul Civic Center in front of a turnaway crowd, has been one of the most active world champions the sport has ever seen. He has defended the world championship all throughout the United States, Canada, Japan, New Zealand, Australia, Europe, the Middle East. You name it, Rick Martel has been there to defend the world championship.
And right now, defending it here against Jimmy Garvin and working over the leg. Rick Martel, look at the physique on this man. Now, he doesn't look like that he's exerting any pressure at all. It doesn't look like he's working that upper body, but you can look at Jimmy Garvin's reaction and tell that the heat is on.
Now, it's double fold here, Larry. He's exerting tremendous pressure on the ankle, but he's also, now he just snapped that hamstring back, but he was also driving his knee into the thigh and hamstring area at the same time he had that hold on.
Right back at it, Rick Martel. Well on his way to becoming one of the greatest champions in history. And he's still such a young man.
Now you can see right there, he's got the step over toe hold on. At the same time, he's got that knee right into Jimmy Garvin's breadbasket that's breaking up his normal breathing pattern. Martel is able to rest. Garvin is having problems breathing, but he was able to work out of the hold. Not a very scientific, but a fist to the head did the job.
Goes to the eye gouge, and now a forearm. Again, do not underestimate Jimmy Garvin. Look at that. The champion of the world at work.
Larry, I had the opportunity to talk to Rick Martel a few minutes before this match, and he was very excited because he felt for the first time wrestling Jimmy Garvin, he did not have to worry about Precious at ringside, what with the presence of Big Bertha in his corner to keep law and order.
So far, that's exactly what's going on. Precious, and you can look at her and tell why, in one way, she's a distraction, and she has her sneaky little ways of accenting it. Now, Garvin trying to get to the ropes. He makes it, and they're going to have to break this hold. But now, without a couple of kicks first, Rick Martel, Garvin exits. Going to get a little friendly encouragement from Precious outside the ring.
Crowd very boisterous in their disapproval and dislike of not only Precious, but of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Now Garvin gets back into the ring.
And Rick Martel right back on him. Look at this. Could be all over. No, Garvin gets out of it.
Count of two, very close to three. Rick Martel right back after the backbreaker.
Again, the cover of that Garvin with his leg over the rope, and Bertha throws it off. Garvin finally kicks out of it.
The camera didn't pick it up. Precious went over to have a word with Big Bertha. Bertha started coming towards her. She beat a hasty retreat.
Rick Martel in total control. Jimmy Garvin down and stunned. Martel goes for the cover again. Can he get him? And once again, Garvin with his foot over the ropes. But once again, Bertha bringing it up. That time the referee caught it. Rick's going to have to bring it up. Right back on the attack. Rick Martel in total control all the way so far. Making it a miserable night for gorgeous Jimmy Garvin.
Look at this move, Larry.
Garvin grabbing the toe.
Larry Martel came down head first with his chin in right square on the top of that turnbuckle. Not the padded area, but the very top. Martel in obvious agony. Totally dazed.
Jimmy Garvin not much better off, but he is at least beginning to make it to his feet. Precious is over there screaming encouragement. Garvin on his feet. Rick Martel, he's out of it, and now Garvin has control of the match. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin is going to send Martel out of the ring because he needs the breather, even though he had Martel stunned. Precious tormenting Rick Martel. Bertha on her way to break it up. You saw Precious scream and run.
The presence of Big Bertha. Big Bertha over to help Rick Martel up. Precious got it, Rick Martel verbally, but she was very careful not to touch him. And I don't really blame her, what with Big Bertha here at ringside.
Rick Martel stunned, hurt, outside the ring. You wonder why he's holding his head. Well, all in the world he's had is the top of the turnbuckle banged off of it and a couple of boots from Jimmy Garvin. However, this is the champion of the world.
I tell you the way, he came down on the top of that turnbuckle with all 238 pounds coming down with it. He's lucky his head is still connected, Larry.
Jimmy Garvin pressing the advantage. You won't see Garvin letting very many opportunities go by. And there's nothing in the world Jimmy Garvin wants more than that belt. He may get it right now. Two, no. Martel kicks out. Jimmy Garvin.
He ain't going nowhere!
Well, you can hear Jimmy Garvin in our handheld camera. His thoughts with Martel, he says, isn't going anywhere as he holds that face lock.
I don't understand how anybody can tolerate that kind of thing. Martel in such good shape.
Shut up!
He could easily, with enough pressure, Larry Nelson, if he gets the proper leverage, literally break the neck of the heavyweight champion, Rick Martel.
Hours and hours of conditioning. Martel knows Garvin. This is one of Garvin's favorite maneuvers, so you know he's prepared himself for this. But how do you prepare yourself for this? It's something I don't know. Chin lock.
Now he goes to that reverse face lock. Guys, also at the same time, Larry, sitting right on the small of the back of Rick Martel. So Rick has got tremendous pressure not only on his neck, but on the small of the back area as well. While he's struggling to get out of it, he's having to absorb the full weight of Jimmy Garvin. Garvin, in the meantime, is basically able to regain his breath.
You can see what Rick Martel's going through. Again, the camera crew with an excellent shot. Look at the heavyweight champion of the world. The concentration, the pain, the struggle. Rick Martel in big trouble, hanging on to the heavyweight championship of the world. Also, keep in mind, one of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin's favorite moves, in fact, his favorite finishing move, is indeed the pile driver. He loves the pile driver, and he is weakening the neck area of Rick Martel. Setting him up for the pile driver, of course he's going to try it. You also know Martel knows he's going to try it. Now look at Rick Martel working his way back. The champion getting in the position he needs. He's got to push Garvin forward to get out of this hole. It's his only escape. He got it. Ooh. Flying elbow right into the champion. Looks more like a forearm now that we see Jimmy Garvin turning the champion over. He's going for the title right now. Doesn't get it. Two count, and that's all. Very close. Two count again. Garvin, face lock.
I'll tell you, Larry, what you got to watch for here. It would be very easy for Jimmy Garvin to slip that forearm underneath the chin and drop this into a chokehold and cut the wind off to Rick Martel, the heavyweight champion of the world.
And you know Jimmy Garvin capable of anything. The only thing that matters to this man is the victory. And he wants that belt more than he wants anything else in the world. Every wrestler worth his salt does. Rick Martel has got the belt, and he's also got a world of trouble. Jimmy Garvin right on top of it.
Well, there's no question. The fame, the glory, and perhaps most importantly, the money that comes with being the heavyweight champion of the world. And these men, believe me, will go to any length to win it. And Rick Martel, to his last breath, will do anything to keep it.
Rick Martel coming back. The crowd encouraging him. Martel trying to keep his feet. That downward pressure off. Now he's going to have to do a tremendous job. He's on two. Martel coming up. Martel powering out. All right. Jimmy Garvin. Second knee to the stomach. Look at Rick Martel, and you wonder how he's going to be able to come back from all this. Soaked in sweat. Martel to the turnbuckle. Now Garvin. Oh, Garvin hung up. I counted five boots to the belly. The champion is gone wild. Garvin is trying to get out of the ring. Runs right into the ring.
Jimmy Garvin rolls to the wrong corner. Oh. Toe to toe.
Life has suddenly taken a bitter turn for gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. It's going to be a suplex. The ring shakes. Martel over the top rope. That is his favorite finishing hold. Garvin knows it. These men have met before. He got the knees up. Both men stunned.
That'll knock the wind right out of Rick Martel. It gives Garvin a chance to regain the momentum. Look at this move by Martel. Here's the flip.
Interference from Precious. Breaks it out. And here comes Bertha. In the ring. Drop kick Martel. Precious the turnbuckle. Garvin the delay. Referee distracted. March out of the top rope, Bertha!
Oh, no! Oh, that's fun, Mary.
That's gotta do it!
Well, wrestling fans, you saw it. Precious started it by interfering, hitting Martel when he had that cradle on Jimmy Garvin. And Big Bertha, Larry, about all we can say, the boundaries of good taste, finished it. Now, look at this. But the bottom line here is Rick Martel indeed retains the heavyweight championship of the world.